because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When John the Baptist heard in prison of the works of the Christ, he sent his disciples to Jesus with this question: Are you the one who is to come, or should we look for another? Jesus said to them in reply, Go and tell John what you hear and see. The blind regain their sight, the lame walk, lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the poor have the good news proclaimed to them. And blessed is the one who takes no offense at me. As they were going off, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. What did you go out to the desert to see? A reed swayed by the wind? Then what did you go out to see? Someone dressed in fine clothing? Those who wear fine clothing are in royal palaces. Then why did you go out? To see a prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way before you. Amen, I say to you, among those born of women, there has been none greater than John the Baptist. Yet the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Have you ever had a question on your mind and your heart that really challenged you, that really bugged you, that really stayed with you for a long, long time? One of those questions that keeps you up at night. I have. In today's gospel, the center question is, who is Jesus? Is he the promised Messiah that was prophesied to come to deliver his people, Israel, from their rulers that occupied their land? Is he the king who was to come to rule over them, the one who brings peace, healing, redemption to his people? What signs would this Messiah give to show that he is the one? John himself had this question. In hindsight, we know that Jesus Christ is the one. He healed the peoples of their blindness. He caused the lame to walk. He raised the dead. And the kingdom was preached to all. As John wrestled with this question, are you the one? Is this man of whom I have been speaking? Everything he is doing seems to point to him. When Mary came to see my mother Elizabeth, I rejoiced in the womb. I was filled with the Holy Spirit. When he came to be baptized, did not the Spirit reveal that this is the Lamb of God? And when he was baptized, did not God speak from heaven, saying, This is my beloved Son? Listen to him. But yet John had this question. So he sends his disciples, go and ask Jesus, are you the one? And what was Jesus' response? He echoed the prophecy of Isaiah. Tell John what you see. The prophecies are fulfilled. The blind see. The dead are raised. The deaf hear. God's mercy is revealed. The prophecies revealed himself God revealed himself to the people. It shows that God came and dwelt among us. You see that Jesus was not coming to rule as a ruler of this world, a man who would take up his reign and rule with an iron fist. No, Jesus came as the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and we heard that before, right? He came to rule the nations with love, with mercy, with forgiveness, with kindness, with compassion, with healing. So, but how do we, each one of us, bear witness so that Jesus is the one in our lives? How do we show by our acts who Jesus is? In order for us to be true witnesses of the Lord, we need to have a relationship with him. We need to know him. And if we truly know him, then we go out and we would proclaim God's kingdom with our lives. And how do we do this? Well, we do this when we defend the life of the innocent from natural birth to conception. We do this when we fight for justice against the evil of this world. We do this when we teach our children to come to know God, when we teach them to pray. We do this when we pray, hope, and fight for all things that are just. We do this when we learn to love unconditionally, when we forgive the faults of others, as well as forgiving ourselves when we fall short. We do this by reconciling ourselves with God, who is mercy and love himself. So let us ponder these questions as we get closer to Christmas. How is my relationship with Jesus Christ? Am I seeking a deeper encounter with God? How do my words and deeds give witness in my life that Jesus is the one? Is Jesus the one, or are we still seeking another?
Let us stand and profess our faith.